will you have?
Sherry, please.
Sherry for the lady and a double martini for me.
Yes, sir.
Well, Miss Hamilton, I don't mind telling you, you can certainly sling those obligatos around.
Thanks.
Hello, Gloves.
Hiya, nice kid. I met her at the junior prom.
Now, what was it you wanted to talk to me about?
Well, I don't know exactly how to begin this, Begin. My old lady had a feeling that you might be able to tell me something about Miller's death. Said she and the neighbors used to see you down at the place quite often.
Of course. I was a customer.
Oh, I seem to remember you were saying this afternoon that it was something personal.
Did I?
Yeah.
I can't remember anything I said. I was so upset.
Well, that makes sense. I'm sorry I bothered you, Miss Hamilton.
Not at all.
See, my old lady was pretty upset. The Millers were good friends of ours.
Yes, I know.
Hmm?
If there's anything I could do for his family, I never met Mrs. Miller, but he certainly was one of the nicest men I've ever known.
Yes, he was okay. My only complaint is that he didn't tell me about you.
Well, that's too bad. He told me all about you, though.
No fooling.
No fooling. He knew you ever since you went to public school 139. Your real name is Alfred, but you keep it a secret.
Yeah, don't you give it away. What else?
You gave him a dozen ties for Christmas. You eat his cheesecake 3 times a day and make every restaurant on Broadway buy it, or else.
Oh, now, wait a minute. Miller never gave you that or else business.
No. Mr. Callahan. And he intimated that you were a no-good double-crossing, chiseling...
Now, which one do you want to believe?
I'll tell you some other time.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Mr. Donahue, but I couldn't possibly leave Mr. Callahan right now. Oh, hello, Pepe. Pepe, this is Mr. Donahue. Mr. Donahue, this is Pepe, my accompanist.
Hiya.
Mr. Donahue is opening a new club in a few weeks.
Oh, is he?
Yes, and he's asked me to work for him.
Oh, he did?
Yeah, it's a brand new idea. I was thinking Miss Hamilton here is quite an attraction.
Isn't she? But we are perfectly happy here, are we not?
Of course.
And now, Mr. Donahue, if you'll excuse us.
I'd like to finish my drink, please.
But we have to rehearse.
Didn't you hear her? The lady said she'd like to finish her drink.
And I said we have no time.
I wouldn't advise you to do that.
Do what?
Listen, Weasel, back to your piano.
Please, Mr. Donahue.
Yeah, well, I don't like the way he's pushing you around.
It isn't important. Please don't interfere.
Come on. Let her alone.
Take your hands off me.
Just a minute, Mr. Donahue. We don't want any disturbance here. I warned you when you came in.
Oh, he's just trying to persuade her to quit Mr. Callahan.
Oh, chiseling again, huh? I'm afraid we'll have to ask you to leave, Mr. Donahue, lightly and politely.
Oh, why don't you shut up? I'm getting hoarse listening to you.
Good night, Mr. Donahue.
And Miss Hamilton.
Now, would you leave? Or do you want to sample of our sudden hospitality?
Okay, Reginald.
Spread a carpet for him on his way out. I want to talk to that dame.
Miller getrieben. Lügt doch nicht so frech. Wieso wärst denn der Donahue gekommen?